Now, in terms of growing up with comedians as daddies, were they funny at home?
No. No.
For my father, it was that he was constantly learning life. It's terrifying. I mean, if you're an actor, you know. It's just the act. Wouldn't it be? It'd be great if they could put a chip in your head. Wouldn't it be great if there were a pill? Wouldn't
they
it
do.
Be great if there? Yeah, well, they probably do. But Jack was always learning lines. Also, sleep with three kids, it was impossible. So I could steal the watch off of your wrist, and you would not know it because we were the quietest kids. We could sneak around an apartment like nobody's business because to wake Jack was like waking the Minotaur. So that was the tension. I don't want to say he wasn't funny, but also the Blacklist produced an amazing amount of rage and turmoil in our household. My parents had horrible fights, and so there was all that. So I don't know whether there was any room to sense of there not being any fun. He was a great father, I think. They all tried their best, but there was an enormous amount of pressure.
Well, Zero could be very nasty sometimes. And every night when we had dinner, I would sit down, and as I sat down, he would say, "Give me a seltzer." Get up and give him a seltzer. You know, it was 2 feet. I could do it. And then night after night, and it got me angry because he was just so demanding, and just as I sat down, he would do this. So one night, I sat down, he goes, "Get me a seltzer." I said, "Why don't you say please?" And he said, "I don't have to say please. It is understood that that please has been said." You say please to every Puerto Rican you bump into in the street. Why don't you say please to your son? At which point, Zero said, "Don't cross me!" And they had a fight, and my mother got up. And ran into the bedroom crying, and we were sitting there, and Zero said, "You've done it," and said something, and I said, "Sure, Adolf."
Oh.
Was that inappropriate? Zero, I was 14 at the time. Zero goes, "If you ever, ever say that to me again, I will stab you. Do you understand? Do you have any questions?" I said, "Yeah. When are you marching into Poland?" Zero had a bus run over his leg, so he was slow, which I knew. And he would chase me around the dining room table. My brother wasn't there. And then I ran to the front door, and there was my brother holding the door open.